Hello my dear students, welcome to our channel Rajesh Biology and I am Rajesh MSc Zoology. Today our topic is the human reproductive system. So human reproductive system means reproductive means re means again and again and again and again. Productive means they were all organisms want to produce their offsprings and they want to continue their biological legacy on this earth, as like humans also, because humans are also a part of kingdom Animalia and they are under the class Mammalia, order primates. Okay, so humans are also have internal urge to generate their offsprings for several generations. Okay, now in human reproductive system there is some events are there. First, we will discuss about the events of the human reproductive system. Later, we are going to know about the male reproductive system. So, first events. The events are gametogenesis. The word gamete means maybe it is a sperm or maybe it is a ovum, whatever it is, that is a gamete. And the production of the gametes is called gametogenesis. If it is from the male reproductive system, the gamete is the sperm. So that is called spermatogenesis. Spermatogenesis. So genesis means producing, generating. Genesis means generating or producing. Gametogenesis, if it is a male, that is spermatogenesis. If it is the female, that is oogenesis. First step is gametogenesis, and the gametogenesis is happened at the age of puberty. At the age of puberty gametogenesis is started, and it is different from male to female. Okay, and individual to individual. It is maybe from 13 years to 15 years in male and 11 years to 13 years in female. So like this, the gametogenesis is different in male and female reproductive system. Once the gametes are produced at the age of puberty, the next step of the reproductive system is insemination. Insemination. Insemination means sending the sperm cells into the female reproductive tract. That process is called insemination. Insemination is transfer of sperm cells into the female reproductive tract. Transfer of sperm cells into female reproductive tract. Female reproductive tract. This is called insemination. So after insemination, the sperm cells are actively swim within the female reproductive tract and they reach the ovum, because in oogenesis ova is already released. And later the next step, as you already know, that is fertilization. Here the fertilization is internal. In humans, the fertilization is internal. Internal fertilization. Some organisms show external fertilization like amphibians. Internal fertilization. But amphibians, fishes, they show external fertilization. But in humans, we can observe the internal fertilization. Fertilization takes place inside the body. And here, two gametes, if it is the ovum, it is the sperm cell. Two gametes are fused to form the zygote. So after fertilization, zygote is formed. Zygote formation. If you observe these two gametes, the female gamete is big when compared with the male gamete. So it's this type of gamete is called anisogamy means both the gametes are different in size. Anisogamy. and it is also called syngamy. Syngamy means syng means fuse, gametes fuse together, so it is a syngamy, anisogamy. This fertilization takes place inside the body, so internal fertilization, and the zygote formed. Okay, zygote formation takes place. Now come to the zygote. Zygote undergo cleavage, and this type of cleavage is in humans, it is holoblastic cleavage. Holoblastic cleavage means the total the yolk material is divided, is undergo the cleavage process. Holoblastic cleavage and radial cleavage. So we'll discuss about the types of cleavages in the further classes, which are not so important in this chapter. Okay, zygote formation. Zygote undergo cleavages. Cleavage means like this. If it is the zygote, zygote divide into two cells. Single cell divide into two cells. Two cells again divide into the four. 4 become 8, okay, and 8 become 16, 16 become 32, like that the embryo is formed by the cleavages, okay, and of course these cleavages also have the different names at different stages, like marula, blastula, gastrula, like that. So the blastula stage get implanted, so after fertilization, zygote formation, the next step is implantation. Implantation. That means the embryo sends its roots into the uterus wall to get implanted. You know, we use the word plantation. Plantation means we dig the soil, we take one plant and we keep that plant in the soil and we close that and plant will grow in the soil. So this type of development is called plantation. Here also same process takes place by its own, that is implantation. So the embryo or the blastocyst, actually the word is blastocyst, perfect word, blastocyst get implanted in the uterine wall of the female reproductive system. Okay, this process is called implantation. After implantation, it will grow in the uterus wall for 9 months. That 9 months period is called gestation. The period of 9 months is called what? Gestation. In this gestation period, the embryo developed into adult one, the fetus one. Like in this gestation period, the blastocyst developed into the bilaminar embryonic disc, and then next trilaminar embryonic disc. 3 primary germ layers are formed, and every germ layer going to form the different types of tissues. You already know that all the 3 germinal layers gives rise to 3 different types of 4 different types of tissues, that is epithelial tissue and muscular tissue, connective tissue, nervous tissue. Like the tissues are formed, organ development takes place, and everything is happened after gestation. After the 9 months of gestation, the delivery of the fetus is called parturition. So these are the steps which involved in the human reproductive system. In human reproductive system, these are the events. And gametogenesis is happened in both male and female. The remaining all are happened in the female reproductive tract. That means fertilization takes place in the fallopian tube. Insemination is into the vagina of the female reproductive system. Fertilization takes place in the ampullary stomach junction of the fallopian tube, that is also a part of female reproductive system. Zygote formation takes place in fallopian tube, and the cleavages occur in the fallopian tube. Implantation takes place in the uterus. During the time of gestation period, the embryo develops in the uterus, and parturition is also from the birth canal. All the remaining all events takes place in the female reproductive system. So first we will discuss about the male reproductive system. What are the male reproductive organs and from where the sperm cells are produced? What is the process of development of sperm cells and the constituents which present in the semen? Everything we will discuss in the next class. Okay. Thank you.